All right, everybody, how's it going? We are here at the home stretch to anniversary 3. We are at September week 2, and we'll be doing a couple of live shows and such. We'll be doing a couple weeks worth of live shows and all that leading up to anniversary 3, which I believe I have tentatively scheduled for Friday week 4. Now, currently, Big R and Marty Skrull are not able to be there, as is Sarah Lee. But I believe I have that set up so that they should be there, because I have Big R as a exclusive paper appearance, so he'll be leaving his stuff soon. As well as Marty Skrull, an exclusive paper appearance, so he'll be leaving these areas as well. How's it going, everybody, by the way, in the chat? Appreciate you guys being here. I do have quite a few things coming up here. If you notice, you'll see... Oh boy, I want to turn that down on my head. My headphones. If you notice... trying to find a good... Yeah, I'll go to 65. Something where it's just ambient music, not like overpowering. If you'll notice, you will see that Tetsuya Naito has one appearance left on his contract. That's because I got a loan agreement for one show for Tetsuya Naito. He'll be showing up at Anniversary 3. That'll be something that I'll announce probably on Adrenaline tonight, where he will face Katsuyori Shibata in a one-on-one match. If you didn't see the video that was posted a couple days ago, he'll come up, but also Degeneration Dash taking on Pete Dunne and a partner of his choosing. If you didn't see the video, the partner of his choosing, of course, Jimmy Havoc, so... bringing him in as well, and I guess I could just show a lot of this here. There's a few more people I'm looking at bringing in. I'll be using the Briscoes, the Young Bucks, basically getting prepared for post-anniversary. Of course, Jimmy Havoc, a new referee, another road agent, James Storm possibly as well, and a couple more women in Leva Bates and Lufisto. I'm getting them in for anniversary. Based off of some ideas that I've had so far, and mostly it's just sort of, let's just get through this here. I will do that. We got a couple of weeks left. The way I'm looking at it is we'll still do our Monday through Friday shows, 1 hour. No happy music? What? But the goal that I have is do my Monday through Friday shows like I have been doing, and it'll just kind of be filled up like this. Do the hour-long shows for week 2 and week 3, and week 4 will be the Adrenaline TV. And then I'm considering, if I did the math correctly, if I do one more show before anniversary, that should get me to my 47 importance. So I might do like I'm planning on doing like a 2-hour like special go home show to anniversary 3 to kind of wrap up everything and get everything settled in before anniversary 3 comes, and that will be the big event. That will be like the last regional event that we do before we go over into Cult. That should be, if I've timed it out the way I have, that should be how it works. So, all I just gotta make sure is I don't have too many real duds here, and I should be A-okay. They do have great lakes, but at this point, I think I'm just gonna keep going. See, they keep saying like 3,200. It's like, no, I'm just gonna... Palace of Malice. Assign that. $9,000 for a 5,000 seat place. We'll fill that out eventually. Not too worried about that. when I reach national TV 2-hour shows. That might actually happen once I hit Colt. Just based off of there might be a whole changeover with the way I create shows. Once I hit Colt, I'm considering making Adrenaline here 2 hours, and then I may also do an additional hour show outside of it. I'll get to that whole thing maybe at the tail end of this. The whole thing though is to just at least get to anniversary 3. That's the main thing here. So, like I said, I think the Monday and Friday shows will be like the actual step it up, do something type of shows, advance the storylines. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday will be like maybe tag team fillers. There might be like one kind of cool main event or just some sort of cool match. Other than that, I think I'm pretty good. So let me see where I hit on Friday, because I want to make sure that I kind of go with where I'm at. Okay. Alright, so based off of a lot of the stuff that I'm doing leading up to anniversary, I guess I will... Let's see. We'll do a one-on-one match to start. And I'm thinking... Let's see here. Okay, I don't know if I officially listed it, but I think I might have one more spot open. I'm trying to see. I don't think I officially did it yet. So I will put Brother Ray in. Drink energy drinks. No, I should have gotten some more caffeine. That's really something else I should have done too. Is get some caffeine. Wow, do I not really have a place for Kushida? Alright. There we go. Hang on here. There we go. Opportunity Trophy Qualifier. That might be the main event. I don't know. These two... I don't know if Brother Ray should be fine. Okay. God, look at his microphone and charisma skills. Is it always been that? Okay, it's always been like that. I don't know why I didn't. So he's not the greatest wrestler. Of course, I think that's just Brother Ray in a nutshell. Not the greatest wrestler, but he's a damn good talker. But we'll give it like, let's see, 16 minutes will just get us over that hump of being able to slow build the match. And let's see, the victor, Brother Ray, we'll make it a tainted win. So he cheated to win to beat Kushida, but he did it. That might be tonight's main event. Alright, let's put on... Boy, where do I sit with, see, I'm trying to remember, it's been a couple of weeks now. I'm still trying to sit with where I was doing certain things. Okay, so last week on Adrenaline, I announced the Kana versus Dash Chisako match, so we can give Dash a little something as well to work with. And let me see here. How many? We have way more faces than we do heels, by the way. I say either Sarah or Riho. Probably Riho. So Dash versus Riho. And we'll give that like... And we might also give that like 16 minutes. I bet you they could probably go. So Victor, open match. Let's slow build it. And we'll make it more decisive for Dash. We want to keep her pretty strong as well. Because, yeah, she's getting up there. Let's see here. So we get Dash versus Riho, and now look at that. We only really have to do like maybe one more match. So like one more match here. If we make it about 10-ish minutes, we'll be able to fill that out, and then we can fill out the rest of the time with angles. So let me see here. Oh wow, Katarina Lee defeated. Oh, poor Riho has got to lose constantly. Let us do. Okay, how many more appearances do I have left on Alpha's Junior's contract? We have 3 appearances left. So if I do something, let's say, this week, I can keep him out next week. I can bring him in on the go-home show, and then Anniversary will be his last show. So let me see. I could do an appearance tonight, 2nd appearance on the go-home show, 3rd appearance at Anniversary, and I've cleared out all appearances. Perfect. So let's see here. We could do a one-on-one. Let's do... Oh, Alpha's not here. God, out of all that, I didn't even need to... Couldn't even really do anything because Alpha Jr.'s not here. So maybe we'll just do a tag match. Is it just TEW? Most likely, yeah. Just TEW. 2 versus 2. Let's see. We got Omega, Kylie, Ladybeard, Skrull. Oh man, I'm not sure at what I want to run actually. Tuesday, week 1. Okay, so Shane Hollister can lead a team with. Hollister can lead a team with. Let's take the women's division out. Kylie. Kylie could probably use a rub. He could use a little bit. So if Hollister's there, let's. Sherman has got plenty of momentum to kill. Not kill, just, yeah. Let's see. Maybe not quite Patrick Clark, maybe someone like a, Sugar Shane, Colby Carino. Carino, I guess, could probably do this. Carino or Big R? Okay, we'll just do that then. Sherman and Carino versus Hollister and Kylie. I'll just stop messing with it. We'll give them like 12 minutes. Hollister will get the win. And I guess, yeah, an open match. We might get a decisive win. If we're gonna, let's, we can have like, we can have Sherman take the loss here. Keeps Carino a little bit, you know, still there. There we go. Carino looks like he's in a porn vid. I mean, that's just a picture I found of Colby Carino. That's a picture I found of Colby Carino that's not like 4 years old. All right. So we've got Dash versus Riho. Now we can fill the last like 15 minutes with angles and such here. Dustin Rhodes not here? What happened? Why is Dustin Rhodes not here? What is he? Why is Dustin Rhodes not here? He's working elsewhere. Where the fuck is Dustin Rhodes at? That's, what is, where is he at? I didn't know someone else picked his ass up. WWC? Oh, boy. Alright, well, I guess it'll save me some money to bring out someone else. Let's start with Dash and Paul Heyman. Dash runs into Heyman to open the show. And Heyman. Heyman can say something. Let me see. Wilson, how's it going? God, I'm trying to see what I want to. Now, he's not directly involved with this, but Heyman could maybe say something. Heyman talks about his interest in Kana. Dash walks away. There we go. We won't even use Dash. Dash won't really even say anything. We'll just give a success to Paul Heyman for that one. Just a couple minutes where Paul Heyman just be like, you know, after the last few weeks, I've grown an interest. Dash can maybe cut a promo then after her match. Let's see. Dash grabs a mic. Tells Kana wherever she is, she'll prove she's better. Of course, I think they would come up with something a little bit better than what I can come up with, but oh well. There we go. Shane Hollister and Kevin Kiley should cut a little promo. A little promo-ski. Entertainment. Hollister and Kylie rant about their opponents. Then Hollister goes off about Alpha Jr. Just a quick couple minutes there to kind of get them both over. Just a little bit more over. There we go. Let's see. We got about 8 more minutes to book stuff. What do I want to... Is there anything else not having a match that I want to push? You know, I guess... let's see if he's here. Broken Matt can carry a good portion of the load here. Broken Matt vignette backstage, where he is training for his match with The Undertaker. Boom. It's like 3 minutes of just, like, of just stuff. There we go. So, stick that there. Brother Ray can maybe say a little something. Maybe. I bet you Kushida can cut a little bit of a promo. How about Brother Ray, then? Brother Ray is backstage. Talks about how... Well, let's see. Oh, God. Sorry. I hate the yawning. I hate the fact that I'm yawning. That might be like a break in between streams. Just go up the road and get like something caffeinated from the gas station. Talks about how he's been forgotten about in the title picture And he was going to fix it. He was going to fix that by winning the opportunity trophy. We'll give him like 3 minutes to say something. Whoops. Eh, we'll give him 2 minutes. We can give him 3 minutes at the end here. Maybe... I'm trying to see... Brother Ray... Kushida... Brother Ray kicks Kushida out of the ring. And celebrates with warning the others in the... Opportunity Trophy match. There we go. Perfect. 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Because he'll beat him down a little bit. And then we can use his entertainment success. I guess it's a... not a major success, a minor defeat. There we go. Boom! 65 minutes, we have pushed this going. We're good. Alright. Alright, so Dashy Soccer running into Paul Heyman. Paul Heyman saying, "No, my, I'm liking Kana, you know, it's great, blah, 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 blah." So he does all that. Dashy Soccer and Riho got a really nice... God, wow. Okay, that's a really nice rating. I did not expect a 75 for that match, I gotta be honest. That's pretty cool. 74 for Dash. Man, this is a hot fucking crowd, man. Dash pulling off a pretty nice promo telling Kana, wherever you're at, she will prove that she is better at Anniversary 3. We go back to Shane Hollister and Kevin Kiley, who are mouthing off about their opponents tonight, and then Shane Hollister as well, talking about Alpha Jr., how not scared he is. Wow, we're really just hitting all cylinders tonight, aren't we? I'm liking this. Yeah, Shane Hollister was clearly above everyone on that one, though. Colby Carino pulled out a 50. I just have to mention that he pulled out a 50, which is actually pretty damn good. For a lower card guy, of course. But, I mean, it's not bad. I mean, we can train him to get better. I think he was maybe in the 30s. At some point beforehand. But yeah. Broken Matt Hardy vignette discussing his match with The Undertaker. Training for his match with The Undertaker. Brother Ray, of course, talking about, you know, how much he's been overlooked in the title picture. He did win that match months ago to get a title shot, and he didn't win his title match. I don't remember giving him the title match, honestly. I forget if I did. I'm pretty sure I did. But either way, he's going to fix that by winning the opportunity trophy. First, he's got to win this match against Kushida. Wow, okay, that didn't do nearly as well as I thought. Kushida only got a 61? What the fuck? What happened? Holding back, fatigued, holding back, chemistry. It was mostly Kushida. And then, of course, kicking Kushida out of the ring. Celebrating, warning the others in the opportunity trophy match, he is coming for them. God damn it. High card Carino porn star incoming. And that is adrenaline. And now we can get on to the rest of the shows here. 1 second. Oh, right. It's been like extremely like the loading times. I think probably using my main computer will be fine. It was long loading times though. If I was trying to do anything on my laptop. We'll see what happens. You and I basketball again? Yeah, I'm hit 3K. Probably not. I'll do something else, I guess. I don't feel like doing... What the fuck? He doesn't want to sign. He doesn't want to sign. Oh, God. I need to find a way to bring these people in. Oh, Okay, Kushida's feeling it. Mark Sherman is turning into a good wrestler. This kid is worth getting behind. I'll tell you what, that's the second person who's talked about Mark Sherman being a good worker. I know some people who are not going to be happy about that one. Matt Cage already got used for his appearances. All right. I could probably wait on most of them. I need to find a way to get Leva Bates and Lufisto in, though. And I got to get a lot of them in, honestly. Let's see. Jay Briscoe, Mark Briscoe, Nick Jackson are still on. So... I really want to do Matt Jackson again. How about I give him 2,000? Not covered. I really need to get them in. Jimmy Havoc is another one as well. You know what? It's probably fine, because if I just get them in here like this, if I just get them in, if I'm turning Colt in just a few weeks, it won't be a huge deal, because I can just easily sign them to a written deal. So we'll just spend more money on them instead of trying to lowball them. We'll spend more money and see if they come in. God damn it, where is she at? Lufisto. Don't make me have to. I mean, to be fair, I can totally, like, overpay for a little bit. I can totally overpay them. Like, I can give her, like, 900. See if that happens. I know they probably don't want to get rid of their other stuff here. Save this here. Don't pay as much like in The Undertaker. No, I'm not going to pay like a shitload of money for them. We'll see. Alright, we have the show tonight. There's something I hate to have to take just like a quick break. But there's something I need to get real quick, so I'm gonna mute my mic. I'll be right back. Just give me like 3 minutes. Alright, there we go. Let's see if... Whoops, that's the console. Alright. Sorry about that. Alright. So now I'm good. Let me see here. I think I'm just getting through... I just need to get through... certain stuff here. You know what I want to see? Oh, God. Fucking Roddy Piper's... It's kind of funny. Roddy Piper's kid is in this. And is apparently an MMA fighter. And not really all that great of a wrestler. We'll just make him the next Matt Riddle. I remember seeing something, and I have to see if anything has happened with it. Because last I knew, oh, I can't even see what the current deals are going on. But apparently, there's a lot of people trying to get Roman Reigns on their roster. And he isn't loyal to WWE, but that's alright. You know what I wish I could do? I wish I could, like, make this bigger. I wish I could, like, resize this to make this basically full screen. I don't know why it's been the same exact thing for, like, 10 years. Ooh! Passes some tips on working as a babyface, just protege Cody Hall. Very nice. I'm liking this. I'm liking the constant passing of tips on... It's helping Cody Hall, I'm telling you. By the way, Colby Carino is also a protege of Jake Roberts, and Patrick Clark is also a protege of Jake Roberts, but it seems weird that Cody Hall is the one that seems to be getting everything so far. Damn, dude! That's a he's a 90 babyface now. Holy shit. By the way, what the fuck does Jake Roberts know how to do? Know about playing a babyface? Wait a second. I just thought about that, too. It's like, wait, he doesn't fucking know? Palace of Malice. There we go. Booking the show. I was going to say, do we make... I'm going to save as much money as I can, because I don't know how much money it's going to cost me to start off when I'm trying to lock everyone down to, like, written deals. But I guess I'll figure that out. So yeah, like I said, just some throwaway stuff to throw some guys in there. We'll maybe bring in like a lower tier, let's say like a Sugar Shane, and then Raj Singh hasn't been used, so like Raj Singh and Sugar Shane Helms. It's a weird combo. Let's do week one. Let's do Joel Redman and we could do Kenny Omega. Redman's carrying an injury, that's fine. Give them like 10 minutes. We will have I want Raj Singh to take the win, but that means Joel Redman's taking the loss, because I'm not giving that loss to Kenny Omega right now. Open match, decisive win. I want Kenny Omega to not give a shit about Joel Redman. So we're gonna keep Omega strong as well. There we go. What else can we book here? We can book like 3 women in a match. Let's see what we got. Who have I used when? Let's see. These are all used Wednesday. Let's do Mayu Iwatani. Oh my god, I got an idea. Mayu Iwatani in with Azumi. And Risa Sarah. And we're going to give it like 12 minutes. Mayu Iwatani. So even though I'm not doing a story, it's kind of fun to have Mayu come out and be like, I'm going to practice for my 3-way dance. And that's how this is going to work. And we're going to have him go all out, which is probably not going to work all that well, is it? Let's see. Maybe we shouldn't do the all out for a great bout. Of cool. I'll give it like 10 minutes. In fact, we'll probably start with that. Seems like a good idea. We could do like a one-on-one match here. Maybe like a decent-sized one-on-one match. We could even make it kind of a longer match. How about... who's kind of the higher tier guys here? Let's put Tangaloa in there, because he hasn't really done much with Tangaloa. And we'll put him in with, Dustin Rhodes just worked. What did he work again? Ah, that's right, the Big O. That was like last week, wasn't it? I don't know if he could pull that off, though. Kushida, Angle. Have we done Tangaloa, Kurt Angle? Is that a match I want to do right now? It's been a little bit. Oh, we got an 84 out of it. Let's do it again. We'll give Tangaloa the win this time, because it looked like... yeah, Kurt Angle beat him, assumedly clean. So we'll do storytelling, an open match. We'll keep Angle strong. Slow build it. And a tainted win. There we go. Tangaloa kind of cheats, but beats Kurt Angle. And now we can use the rest of the time to just book angles and such. Get some people some talking time. Like, say, Mayu with, let's say, Ron Killings, since they're there. Let's see. Degeneration Dash are talking. Killings got her a warm-up three-way dance for her. I was just going to put warm-up three-way, but then I realized that that'd probably sound really bad. So, success on both. There we go. Raj Singh. Get some entertainment time. Raj Singh promo about his match tonight. And anniversary in 2 weeks. Alright. Let's see. Give it like 2 minutes, I guess. Put that right there. We'll do Joel Redman, Kenny Omega. Let's see. Omega is pissed at Redman for losing and takes his frustrations out on him. Boom. Sorry. I'm trying not to move my mic around too much, because I don't know if that makes too much sound, but yeah. Let's see here. Let's do 3 minutes. We can do selling. Let's say, oh wait, no. Success there. Maybe a minor defeat there. And we still got a little bit of time here. Let's do Kurt Angle, entertainment, minor success. Kurt Angle's backstage discussing Alex Reynolds. Let me see. Angle's backstage discussing Alex Reynolds. And vows to beat. Oops. Tangaloa again. Because he already did it once, so why not? 2 minutes there, throw that in there. Kurt Angle, Tangaloa, selling. Angle, Loa celebrates his win. Whoops. Let's see, Angle chases him up the ramp, and Angle locks him on the stage. There we go. Now we can leave the people home. We can send the people home happy. There we go. Looks good. Run the show. Very good start. All right. Setting up that three-way dance. That three-way dance did about as well as I assumed. Wow, Azumi at 15 did better than 26-year-old Risa Serra. Raj Singh, of course, definitely knows how to cut a promo. That was definitely a good idea as well. Wow, okay, a lot of stuff happened there. Raj Singh and Sugar Shane Helms showed excellent chemistry when teaming together. Raj Singh was head and shoulders above everyone else. Wow! Dude! Do you see that 92? I feel... Am I just wasting Raj Singh away right now? That is a 90 fucking 2. I guess we can really see what happens in that opportunity trophy. If he could pull that off too. Omega got a 77, so that's good. Sugar Shane's not suited to his gimmick, that's fine. Redman and Omega, you know, Omega takes his frustrations out on Redman. Angle does his deal. 74 for their match, not too bad. They have great chemistry and it showed in their performance. And nothing to show about the end of the match there. Okay. Raj Singh's gonna be praised. I'm gonna give it up to Kenny as well. And let's do Kurt. Please. All right. Can you imagine if someone was just like all full of piss and vinegar because I praised them? You did amazing! Shut the fuck up! That was all my sweet tea. May have to do something about that. Alright, Marty Skrull's done with his stuff. That's cool. 0.15 TV rating. Oh no! Sammy, no! Oh, he's working through it. Okay. Spoilers, Sami Zayn's contract is coming up. I think it's still at least like a month or so out. But yeah, it's coming up. Did I see Devin Booker drop 70 points? Oh yeah. None of you followed me on my Twitter. I talked about it there. No, it's fine. Yeah, I talked about Devin Booker's 70. Okay, that seemed to have worked, by the way. They seem to be a little bit better about potentially signing now. So that's good. I do want to try... I do want to try to get a new not covered. Did I give him that little last time? Should I have not done that? Nah. I could probably wait for the Tom Pritchard thing, but I think I'll try to get him now. We'll just do the 1800. Not covered. There we go. Yeah, he's only 20. I think that's... I'm gonna have to remember all the people I was trying to make sure I brought in. He has good acting skills. There was more people, I gotta try to remember. Alright, first off, Risa Nakajima signed with Wrestle 1. That's fine. Leva Bates. Okay, Leva Bates is cool with her dealio. Leva Bates needs to be assigned a position and a gimmick. We will auto-push. I want to make sure I'm auto-pushing the right people. Let's see. Dustin Rhodes, Eric Bischoff, Jake Roberts, Jonathan. Okay, cool. Everyone else is a wrestler of some type. Or manager. I guess Paul Heyman should also be... I don't know. Do I have Paul Heyman? Okay, Paul Heyman's also in that. Oh, Mayu Iwatani shouldn't have to be put in there either anymore. Because she is a... She is a full-on wrestler. Alright, Leva Bates needs a... Leva Bates needs a gimmick. See what she can do. Hang on, first off. There we go. What gimmick should we give her? I want to do a heel gimmick. There's no wholesome heel gimmicks, though. I kind of want to see if there is a wholesome heel gimmick. I can't imagine there being one. It's just... The word wholesome and heel just can't coexist. Wow, really? I guess ones that could be babyface as well, but like... Oh, damn. I still have the stream loading here. Oh, damn. Alright, what the hell else can she do? God, she can do legitimate. Let me see if I can just find something without... Is there something without the nun? Let me just do that. Because there's a certain... There's a thing I want her to be, but, like, I don't think wholesome really fits it. Like, not even law enforcer. Maybe Trueborn? Trueborn might be it. We'll do that. Why not? We'll do Trueborn. Sounds cool. Alright. Shit, did I not run my Oh, god damn it. I didn't run my Wednesday show like a dum-dum. That's what happens when I don't remember. Now that might throw things off. Shit. Whoops. No, we're on... Oh, God, we are on Thursday. God damn it. Why does it say Wednesday? Why does it act like there's... anything... there. Jesus Christ. It might still be fine. If I'm running a two-hour show, it might still be fine, actually. So I'm not gonna panic right now. God, I'm stupid. Why did I? Ugh. GG. Assign this venue. There we go. Turn this down in my headphones. Yeah, that's a lot louder than I thought it was going to be. I'm going to turn that down. Let's see here. GG. yeah, I think I might be fine, though. I think I should be fine. Alright, so my Thursday show, let me see. Let me just throw in another... Once again, another tag team match. Let's do Tozawa. Okay, so we need another heel with Tozawa. Kevin Kiley really considered an opener? It's odd. Alright, Tozawa and... Oh, man. Tozawa and Kiley doesn't really fit, though. Tozawa and Yano does, though. Oh, Tozawa and Yano. Who are they going to beat up on? They're going to beat up on Mark Sherman. And let's say Big R. Might be a little bit of something I can do with that. Tozawa will get the win. Bit of storytelling. Open match it. Decisive win. Despite the fact that Yano's there, I think Tozawa would go for a decisive win. Can I have an event at the Palace of Auburn Hills in Detroit? There's been a... Yeah! Why do you think I call this the Palace of Malice? And it's in Detroit. I mean, it's not Auburn Hills, Michigan, but yeah, it's Detroit. There's a reason why I call it the Palace of Malice. Let's see. How about a... Let's do Fatal 4-Way. Let's do some faces, some heels. Maybe the Fatal 4-Way could be the women's match. You can put Hamada in there with, say, Evie, Hikaru Shida. Let's see. We'll put Kimberly in there. I don't know if I want to put Leva Bates. I don't know if Leva Bates is someone I want to put in, like, immediately. Maybe, like, a Mia Yim? There we go. I bet you we can give them, like, 17. Yeah, these are people who could probably all... I could probably run it for a little while. Hamada or Shida? Who could use it a little bit more? Hamada's there. Shida's very good. God. You know what? I think I might give it to Hikaru Shida. Let's do open match, slow build, decisive win. Who can take the fall then? Let's give it to Kimberly. I forget where they're at in the realm of momentum, but I think Kimberly might be okay. I wouldn't be able to tell on that page. Alright, so then another match. Let's say a one-on-one. Let us do maybe a top-level talent. Shibata Angle. Let's do Shibata. We could do Tama Tonga maybe on Friday. Yeah, so Shibata can face... Oh, man. Yano, Big O. Oh. Didn't we do Shibata versus Big O? Pretty sure we've done that. We've done Shibata versus Hollister a bunch. I don't know if we've done Shibata versus Reynolds. We did it in the GP and then at the Grand Prix final. Oh yeah, that's right. They were the Block B final. So we'll do Shibata Reynolds again because that was June. We'll give him like 13 minutes. God, how'd that work out? Shibata beat him both times. Alright. I kind of want to give Alex Reynolds a win, but I need to work this. Alright, I got it. Alright, so open match, I think we can call it in the ring. We're going to do a cheap win, and it's going to be... Rage DQ finish. So Reynolds is going to piss off Shibata, and he's going to fucking pay for it. In the form of getting the shit kicked out of him so much that the referee has no choice but to disqualify Shibata for... not stopping to kick the shit out of him. Yes, alright. And it makes Shibata look like a badass. I'm sorry, what? Why is Shibata DQ'd? Oh, he killed Alex Reynolds? Okay, that makes sense. By the way, medical-wise, hopefully we're not... Okay, Kushida is pretty much the one guy we shouldn't be using. By the way, Io Shirai and Joel Redman are starting to get over their stuff, so that's cool. It's been a while. Let's see here. Let's do... Oh, man. Yano can kind of... I think Yano can speak English at this point. Yeah, he can speak fluent English. Akira can, too. I can't remember if he's really a promo guy. Wow, look at the charisma, man. Has it been like that? Wow, okay. I don't know why I, like, didn't think that... Okay. We're gonna have to have them spend 5 minutes opening the show. They're gonna spend 5 minutes opening the show. Why not? Show opens with Tozawa and Yano watching Yano's DVD. They cut a promo, and Yano shills his DVDs. It's gonna be ridiculous. There we go. We're once again, I think, going to use Mia Yim for her sex appeal. Oh my god, should we utilize somebody for this? Okay, I gotta find out something real quick. I apologize. Okay. This is gonna be stupid. This is gonna be fucking stupid. Mia Yim congrats Tozawa post-match. Tries to seduce him. Tozawa. Okay. Let me see how I do this. Let me see. Tozawa spits on the floor after learning. Ah! Tozawa refuses when he learns she's Korean. Oh no! The hell? There we go. He learns she's Korean. Perfect. I thought I heard like pounding. I don't know. I don't know if that was like a... I think I would have known if it was a neighbor or not. I don't remember. Oh well. So I wanna use that. I wanna use that racist gimmick up a little bit. I don't really do much with that. So let's do something with that. That legendary racist gimmick of Akira Tozawa. You're Korean. It's perfect, is it not? Let me see here. Let's see, Ayaka Hamada and Hikaru Shida. Entertainment. Shida... celebrate as Hamada comes back in the ring, stares her down. Shakes her hand. There we go. I guess they'd be selling the match, would they not be? Probably a better idea. Shibata, Alex Reynolds. We'll do a quick angle. Quick angle with Reynolds. Reynolds backstage promo about Shibata and says, let me see. Backstage promo about Shibata. You will show Angle what. Show Angle what he's capable of. Here we go. Just a couple minutes on that. Do minor success there. Put that down in there. Let's see. Katsuyori Shibata. Alex Reynolds. Dustin Rhodes. So let's do selling. And I'd say acting on his part. I'm not the biggest fan of that, but... Yeah, maybe that. Shibata refuses to stop beating Reynolds. Refs come out to break up, including Rhodes. There we go. Give that like 3 minutes. But I think that definitely puts him over. Definitely, I'd say a low risk of injury here as he's continuing to beat down upon him. Maybe medium risk just because it's Shibata. God damn! Wow! It's the best goddamn start. That is the hottest start I think I've had. Period. That is insanity. Holy shit, that's the best thing I've ever done. As it turns out, a promo between Akira Tozawa and Tori Yano, where they watch Tori Yano's DVD and then Yano shills his DVD, happens to be the single greatest 5-minute segment we've ever done. That is insanity. The segment rating was limited for being short. Which means if I gave them an extra, like, 2-3 minutes to shill DVDs, I think it probably would have gotten 100. That's crazy. Well, Tozawa got a 92. Holy fucking shit. Why are you saying wow like the Kazoo Kid? What? I don't know. I'm just saying wow. Either way, Tozawa defeated Mark Sherman by pinfall. Sherman needs to be taken down a couple pegs, I think. It's not that I don't like him. At least not nearly as much. I don't dislike him nearly as much as some of the other people. Wow, that didn't go over nearly as well as I thought. Oh, well. Oh, another great match. Wow. Yeah, Mia Yim was kind of the weak link there, and Hamada carried it with Shida. Still, pretty good. Shida celebrates her win. Hamada comes back in the ring. They have a stare down. They shake hands. Reynolds is talking about his match with Shibata. He wants to show Kurt Angle what he's capable of, and he does so by pissing off Shibata so bad. Oh no, he sprained his hip. God damn it. He got disqualified going into an attacking range. I don't know how bad that is, though. I guess we'll see. A sprain. Okay, Shibata, Alex Reynolds, Dustin Rhodes. Yeah, so that whole deal. He's sitting there with a sprained hip, and he's still beating the shit out of Alex Reynolds. 80! Katsuyori Shibata, Ayako Hamada, and Akira Tozawa are going to be praised for the level of performance that they have created. Perfect. I'll take it. Oh, man. Alright. Where do we sit here? Jimmy Yang, 01, made an offer to Jimmy Yang. Oh, yeah, that's right. That was a thing. That he was a part of Dragon Gate or something in this mod. And now he's not. It was signed by Dragon Gate for a little while, and then they got rid of him. And Jimmy Yang seems to be actually pretty good as a wrestler. It's kind of amazing. Shibata, okay, so what does that mean for him physically? Okay, so he's showing signs of fatigue. So Shibata's a guy who should probably rest until, maybe even until Anniversary 3, if I just keep him away for the next 2 weeks. Then it'll be up to New Japan to fuck him up, and I'll feel much better knowing that I didn't fuck him up. God damn. Alright, the effects of a grueling schedule, Big R is feeling the same way, that's fine. Jimmy Yang is hardcore, I know, it's fucking great. schedule, yeah, we need to book this again. We need to book another event tonight. There we go, and I think this will be just about the end of the week here, so yeah, we did do one less show, didn't we? Maybe I should just do a Saturday show instead. Let's see. Still making good money. But yeah, I want to make sure I save every dime of this money, because when I turn cult and I start doing written deals, I don't know how much it's going to cost me, and I don't know how much money I'm going to end up losing during this, but I'm at least going to try. I'm going to see what I can do. So we'll see what happens. That being said, I guess we can go into Friday. And once again, if I can get this taken care of, if I can get this all done pretty quickly, I'll be pretty good to maybe, because I plan on doing 2 weeks. If I get this done early enough and I feel like it, I could actually do Anniversary 3 tonight. It could be a possibility. Oh, Joey. He unveiled a series of spot-on impressions of some of his colleagues. He kept people in a great mood with his hilarious road stories. Oh boy, I can only imagine what road stories Kurt Angle would have. Big R's working elsewhere. Oh boy. So where are we at? No, we need more. We're right there. We are seriously right there, man. 48. It's not that far away. All right. So I guess this is a bit more of the actual storyline. Let me see here. So we're doing some of the stories we worked with.
Oh, Jesus.
We worked with Adrenaline doing that. Let me see. Alright, we should do a match. What do I want to work on? Oh, you know what I should do? You know what? I might save it for next week. I think next week I'll do a 3-on-3 with the people in the Opportunity Trophy match. Well, then again, a lot of them are New Japan guys. So I don't know if they'll be there. Let me see. Kenny Omega works New Japan, so we'll see what his schedule looks like. Oh, I know I can do it. There we go. All right, he'll be. Oh no, potential bookings is there. Okay. All right, so New Japan will be week 1, but week 3 seems like I can do that. Okay. So I'll just book that then. Jesus. But I do want to do a bit of a match. Let's do a... Yeah, we'll do a triple threat. What should we do here? Let's do... Tangelo already fought. Toriyano fought. Omega fought. Omega fought on Tuesday. So we'll do Omega. We'll do Raj Singh. And... Brother Ray? Yeah, Brother Ray. And Omega and Singh. Okay. That could be the main, I guess. I think the only person who might not have the good stamina is Brother Ray. But I think if we do 16 with the slow build, it'll be fine. So do that slow build, open match. Victor, Singh. Brother Ray will take the loss. And we'll do decisive win. Oh, we already did that. Match should be open, match should be decisive. Slow built, and that'll be the storytelling. So three of the guys in the Opportunity Trophy ladder match will probably main event this show. I don't think we've done a Kana match. So let's... When was the last time I used Kana? And that was a week and a half ago, so let's find someone for her to face. Katarina Lee... You know what? I'm gonna do something cool with Leva Bates. How about that? Kana versus Leva Bates. And can Leva handle? Yeah, okay. So we'll do like 17 minutes. Kana will get the win in an open match. Storytelling. Slow built. An intentional countout finish. So the whole thing is that Leva Bates technically lost, but it's because she, on her own, decided to up and leave. So there we go. And then we really only need like one more reel. In college basketball, my next opponent is Kansas. Oh God. Sorry, I didn't have my chat up for a little bit. Did I finish college basketball with my face in Kansas? I don't know. I didn't do college basketball. I've only been doing TEW. But, yeah. So I guess one more match. What should I... yeah, just a tag match to throw in. And we'll make this like the let's just give people their due. Let's give Alpha Junior a match. Who can work with him here? Pete Dunn, Tama Tonga. Let's do Pete Dunn. I was gonna do Cage, but that's fine. And then how about, oh boy, how about the Lady Beard? The Big Beard and Lady Beard. There you go. Base, baseball. Oh! Sorry. I saw Kansas and I was like, eh. I don't know. I didn't finish the season. I still have games left. I have to see. Yeah. Maybe I should get that caffeine. Maybe I should do that at some point before I do more of this. So 10 minutes should be enough. And we want to give Afa Noai Jr. the win. I'm going to keep the big beard strong. However, big beard is going to get choked out. Whoops. It's going to be an open match. It's going to be a decisive win. And we're going to get a... we're going to get a stoppage finish. We're going to get the big beard choked out. And I think that'll open. Are we going to do Conor Leva Bates to close it? That's all right. All the caffeine. I should go up to the gas station. We have a truck stop that's open 24 hours, and I found out that it has like every Arizona tea that I want, because usually there's like specific places that do specific ones, and then this pilot truck stop is just like, no, we got all of them. Come get all of them. It's like, oh shit, you even got mucho mango. I fucking love you. And it's got like 85 different kinds of like iced coffee and shit. I should really just run up there. Let's see, the big beard, Lady Beard. I should give Lady Beard more promo time, because I think that's the only way he's really gonna improve. So I should probably just do that. So entertainment and entertainment. Oh, you know what? Menace. There we go. Lady Beard opens the show. Taunting the Baka Gaijins. Then flexes as Big Beard flights him. There you go. 4 minutes of that. It's going to be 4 minutes of Lady Beard talking down on people because they're filthy Americans. Even though he's an Australian. It'd be better if I could have him do an Australian, like, doing hybrid Japanese English. Just English. Even though he can speak English perfectly fine. let's do FNI Jr. Lady Beard. Lady Beard checks on Big Beard. FNI Jr. looks to choke out Lady Beard. Until he leaves. There you go. So just intimidation. And a major success. It's kind of cheating the system, but I'm goddamn gonna get Lady Beard over. He is getting over. It's starting. It's starting to happen. We're getting there. I just need to do more. So he still gets over even in a loss. Let's see here. Kenny Omega brother Ray. Omega and Ray argue about the Opportunity Trophy. Vow to take care of Singh tonight. So they're working together to take care of Raj Singh.
Should work out. I think that's... Is that Raj Singh getting the victory?
Yeah. Here we go. Can she... I guess I didn't even see. She can't really talk all that much. That's alright. Leva introduces herself. And introduces her... What should I call this? Her entity, Leva Corp. And discusses it. There we go. So we'll give her like 4 minutes to talk. And I'm now thinking maybe I should push this back a little bit and let Omega Singh Ray be the opener here, or be the closer. Leva Leva refuses to continue fighting. Kind of mocks her on her way to the back. There we go. Yeah, probably a good idea that I put that up there like that. I don't really feel like doing a closing angle. That'll just be the end there for that. Alright, I think we're good. Let's see here. Good start, good solid start. Yeah, with Big Show doing his menace, it seems to really help. Lady Beard looked dreadful in this segment. Oh boy, ugh. an okay match. Pete Dunne was head and shoulders above everyone else. FNOI Jr. is just not all that great. Even Big Show is doing better. And Pete Dunne's just carrying the rest of them. And then that was a thing. Leva Bates introducing yourself didn't do all that hot. Connor Leva Bates did pretty okay. Probably would have done a little bit better if it had like a decisive finish. And no, it was well booked. Okay. Maybe that's just the best I could get out of it. Yeah, boy. All right. Strong end. Strong end. Come on, strong end. There's my strong end. Alright. Raj Singh, definitely. Brother Ray was struggling to keep up with him. Cool. Alright, it all worked. Yeah. Oh, cool. Okay. By the way, this worked. I'm happy this worked. Because what I did when I also came back was I quickly changed out my skin and made sure that my new one was on there, so... seemed to work out well. Raj Singh, Pete Dunne, and let's do the Big Beard. Let's see. Yeah, just compliment them all. That's what I should do there. God. I feel like... There we go. 65. Alright. Let's see. 0.14 TV rating. That was good. Alright. Mark Briscoe. Face. Matt Jackson. Or Nick Jackson. Heel. It's weird that they're suggesting the Bucks be faces and the Briscoes be heels. Oh, good. We can already do that. There you go. Tom Pritchard, road agent. There we go. All right, so we got a few more guys coming. Who am I missing of the people that I actually put in there? Looks like... Oh, no, I never did sign him to a contract. I wanted to get a new... I wanted to get another referee. I wanted to basically flat-out replace my old one. So, we're going to do that. And I think with Justin King, we can now officially do that. Where is he at? Where is he at? There he is. Oh, not negotiate. Just release him. There we go. Who did we sign? Justin King. There we go. It's like I knew this in advance. Who the hell else? What was that? Oh. Lufisto. There we go. That's a newer one. And no alter ego. There we go. Big beard is straight, lady beard's a girl. Remember that? Back, did you miss anything? Not much. I'm just finishing up the week. Finishing up the week, getting some people signed and taken care of. Oh my god, that even more babyface Nick Jackson from 2009. There we go. Alright, I think that's all of it. Okay, so... let me make sure I got this right. There should be two road agents. Jake Roberts and Tom Pritchard. Oh. Oh god, that's Tom Pritchard too. What the fuck? Like, I knew, like, his old school look, but... There we go. Okay, two road agents. There should be three refs now? Let me see. Okay, so me and Toby Keith, the on-screen guys, two referees, there's going to be a third. Undertaker's pushed as a color commentator. That's not right, but we have an announcer, color commentator, and a manager. Alright. So the Undertaker needs to not be that. He needs to be occasional wrestler. He's a retired occasional wrestler. I just want to make sure he's not doing color. Let me do an auto push. Put the Undertaker in it and then auto push everybody to see where they sit now. So where are my main eventers? All right, Naito, I guess, but he's on loan. Tangaloa, Kushida, Tama Tonga, Alex Reynolds, Kurt Angle, the Big O on the next. Rhodes, Singh, Jackson, Yano, Hollister. I'm a little sad how far down I gotta go to find like multiple guys who happen to not be New Japan guys as well. I guess the Big O and Angle and Reynolds, but. Am I starting a tag team division? That may or may not be the plan. Once we get to Colt, of course. That'll be that. Let's see. Lufisto, Mark Briscoe, and Nick Jackson all need characters. So yeah, I'm getting ready to start a tag division. Alright, a wholesome face seems to be her wheelhouse here. So let's do a wholesome face. All-American. Yes, the Canadian girl is All-American. Oh my god. Comic book hero. trying to see if there's anything else I might want. Equality fighter? That might be one I could do. Hang on. Leprechaun. Pacifist, patriot, simpleton, the traditionalist. I may actually do comic book hero. She doesn't have to be like a straight up superhero with like a mask and cape and everything, but stop with the cocky cheerleader. A comic book hero to be like the foil to some of the other, like maybe like Leva Bates might be like a bit of a villain. I don't know. Kenny Omega is, I think, a comic book villain. No, he's not. Oh yeah, that's right. He's fucking fake Japanese. That's what I did. Mark Briscoe. Is it really going to be anything other than like all American or redneck? Let's be honest here. A legit. How can he not be a good babyface? I don't like this. I don't like this deal. Not redneck? Okay, all American it is. Can't be anything else. Like, what am I gonna do? Marshall? Oh my god, I forgot about, like, his fucking redneck karate or whatever he is. Oh, blue collar. Badass. Blue collar is about as... That's about as Briscoe as you can get right there. Alright, Nick Jackson. It's, what, cocky heel? Goddamn, if I hear cocky cheerleader in the goddamn... Cocky heel. Goddamn it. No. No. He could be a chosen one. That doesn't make sense. Degenerate? Degenerate's the closest thing to what he actually is. A knockout artist. Oh my god. A fucking hustler. Oh my god, can you imagine the Young Bucks showing up as, like, fucking hustlers? Oh my god. Cocky gay, oh my god. Dude. Fuck. Dude, seriously, if Matt Jackson can play gay as well, I could totally just turn the Young Bucks into the ambiguously gay duo, and I will fucking love it. Dude, I'm doing it. This would be a lot of people going, like, I always wondered, where'd I find that Leva Bates picture? I mean, I mostly Google images everything, so... Yeah, below hand, you see her, like, holding a rose or something, so... Dude, if I can do the ambiguously gay duo, my life will be complete. I think I'll have like half a million. I think I'll have at least $500,000 before we get to anniversary. So, I think I'll be able to set up with a fair amount of money leading into Colt. So I shouldn't have to worry too much about losing a bunch of money. Wow, this is doing its thing. Don't spill. You son of a bitch. Give me a second. You know what? I'm gonna wait because we're right there. We got like 1 day left. So give me like 1 second. All right, Big R is gone. AWA have made a contract. What? AWA? Oh, okay. A made up one. Okay. Jay Briscoe. Face. Complete the contract. Jimmy Havoc. Face. Complete. James Storm, face. Pay rise request from Alex Reynolds. 75%. Still waiting on Mac Jackson and Brian Hebner. What's your risque for the product? Probably not a lot. None. There's no risque. I don't know why. I should. I wonder if I turn it to, like, very low. What if I turn it to very low? Okay, I could turn it to low, and I should be fine. So there's going to be a low bit of risque. Perfect. All right. It's low risque. All right, so we need to just auto push them all here. Everyone's been assigned their spot. Storm, Briscoe, and Havoc. All right. So, James Storm. Come on. Oh, look at that. Should I even... So, let me see. Cocky, legitimate, brute. Let's just go down to Red Deck and see if we can find one. Rebel? Nah, Redneck. Complete with stereotypical accent and overalls. Oh, shit. White rural laboring class, especially the southern United States, standing up for those who can't stand up for themselves. I could just see it now. Just beer open. Beer! MAGA! Banana! How can you not load the stream? That's really... That sucks. Sorry you can't load the stream. That... I don't know why. Jay Briscoe and Jimmy Havoc. Oh, your Wi-Fi, okay. There's just gonna be so much redneck on our dude, just because James Storm plus the Briscoes is gonna be the most rednecky rednecks that ever rednecked. What is he, a legitimate face? Everything just got so much more southern. All-American blue collar. Am I gonna give him the blue collar gimmick too? Makes sense. And then Jimmy Havoc, which is probably gonna be insane. I can only imagine how old that picture is of him. He looks like he came straight out of like, oh, what is it? 3 Days Grace? Yeah, I think it's like three. let's see. What do we got? We're looking at Babyface. Cool. Ooh, a crazy. We haven't had a crazy one in a while. I like a good crazy character. Lunatic. Perfect. The lunatic fringe Jimmy Havoc. The most rednecky rednecks to ever redneck, of course. It's going to be fantastic. There we go. And then advance that many days. Oh, as I'm moving stuff around. I am pouring liquid from one container into another so that I tried to put a large cap on a small thread. There we go. Alright, so there's that, and we have got Matt Jackson. Matt Jackson is here. There we go. And Matt Cage wants a lot of money. Wow, he's worth too much. auto push, now that Matt Jackson's here. Now where do we look? Kushida, Angle, Shibata, Loa, Tama, Naito, Reynolds, Big O. then Omega, Big Beard, Nick Jackson, Shane Hollister, Singh, Jay Briscoe, Yano, Rhodes, Tozawa. Interesting. Where'd Raj Singh fit again? Upper mid-card, okay. By the way, there's going to probably be some restructuring once we hit... Cold. There'll be some restructuring. Okay, so now that we have 1 week done, this will be a good time for me to cut the video, at least for YouTube, for the people watching this on YouTube. Of course, I'm going to still keep going on stream, but I want to at least cut this off for them. So you people on YouTube, thank you very much. I greatly appreciate it. We are so close. We are like a week and a half away right now, because I have anniversary tentatively scheduled for Friday week 4. Now, good, good, because the Young Bucks were going to be gone in PWG, so I don't know if that's going to be a thing, actually, because I'm pretty sure I signed at least Matt to... Oh, God, I forgot to... There we go. Matt Jackson, and then who else was it that didn't have a... Was it just Matt Jackson? I think it was. Yeah, everyone else seems to be pretty okay. Cool. Okay. I was just making sure. So yeah, we are like not far away from having the next from having anniversary 3. I don't know why I can't speak now. God, he can't do heel? Bullshit. Bullshit, he can't do heel. Weasel. We don't have a good weasel heel. So let me just do this real quick. And I'll cut off the video. I apologize. I needed to do this first. Joker. Prima donna. A prima donna and a gay. A gee. He's the sidekick to Nick Jackson. That'd be fucking amazing. Alright. How about that? So one loves men, the other loves himself. I can just see it now. Matt, I know we're brothers, but I love you. Matt's just like, I love me too. Turn up the risque to high. Let's do this. All right. So, yeah, those of you watching on YouTube, thank you so much. Those of you watching on stream, I'm just going to take a couple minutes, and then I will be ready to go again. So thank you, guys. And, catch you for the next week.